Hey, I'm Carmen, for anybody that doesn't know yet. And I've had an awesome experience just as a teenager in youth group growing up. And Tug was our youth pastor, and he let me play guitar even though I wasn't that good at the time. But now, 11 years later, here I am again. And this song we're going to start with, Set a Fire, has become a really, really powerful song with the youth group. And I need y'all on your feet now.
Thank you. Thank you. once that we went to in Wildwood. It was like a couple days we spent there in hotels, but it was pretty cool.
where we all give a little message. Dear God, thank you for bringing us here today, and thank you for all of you who came, even due to the weather. Thank you for the support, and thank you, Carmen, for the worship. This is a really big chance for us to show you all and God what we've accomplished through the past year. In the name of your Son, amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hello, everybody. Can you all hear me? Hi!
Hi!
Hi! You're my favorite. You're also my favorite. You're okay. Hello. I guess we already said it, but I'm Grace.
Hi, Grace!
Hi!
Hi!
That's also Grace.
Hi.
Hi, Grace, too.
But she's like the like knockoff, like, you know. I couldn't hear that from you. But I'm better, so... Oh my gosh! Okay, that wasn't me. Anyway, we're here to talk to you guys about basically our youth group and how much your support has meant to us, like fundraising for the mission trip. I know we said all the thousands of dollars you guys have raised is just amazing. We all appreciate it so much. And, well, let's start off by talking. What did you say your name was? Reese's Peanut Butter Cup?
Sean bestowed me with the name Reese, but it's Marissa. But everybody, like, BBS, I was Reese, Reese, Marissa, Reese Peanut Butter Cup. It was everywhere. Okay. But we have a mission trip in 2 weeks. We are going to the Blue Ridge Mountains. So excited. Completely different stuff from Niagara Falls. But for a good chunk of us, when we all came together last year for the mission trip, we didn't know each other. It was strange, but all of us were fitting a van for 10 hours, driving to Niagara Falls. Many stops for pee breaks. Wars were coming out everywhere in the vans, screaming songs, especially my cousin who was not here. But it was something. We all learned something very great during the mission trip last year. We all came together as one amazing group, but we also were able to experience such a completely new level of serving God. And I feel like some of us, Xander and Brennan, were not able to come last year. But we all were able to experience such a great extent to serving God and being able to serve such an amazing community. And we were able to put smiles on so many people's faces, and we were able to meet so many other youth groups that wanted to do the same thing that we all wanted to do. And there were tears shed last day for many reasons, and we were all leaving each other, but also how it just changed us in such an amazing way. And I'm so thankful for that experience, and I'm so thankful for all the new people, especially Natalie, Matthew. Everyone new this year, how we've become such a group, and we were able to experience this in the next 2 weeks, which I'm very excited about.
So as Reese said, I didn't go on the mission trip last year. I think I joined like 2 weeks to the youth group after they got on the mission trip. So I heard all the good stories. I saw all the videos they made, the pictures and memories. And at first I was terrified because I knew none of these people except Grace over there. And I was, you know, I grew up in a non-religious household, so it was a very strange world for me. But over about the past year, this has become my family, and I've never been on the mission trip, but I can say wholeheartedly, I am so excited. I get to serve people through God, and I get to do it with my favorite people for a whole week. A whole week. I spend maybe a weekend with these people. I get to spend a whole week with them. That's like amazing. Yeah. But as a new person, I was scared at first, but I learned that God is with us all the time, mm-hmm. And I may be worried, but at the end of the day, it's going to be okay. And even if it doesn't go the way I thought, it's going the way of God's plan. And I've learned that that enough is to trust that everything will be okay at the end of the day.
Mm-hmm.
So, that's just my piece. And you know, thank you all for the support you've given for us to go on the mission trip. It means so much. And I think I can say for the rest of them, we are so excited to go. It's going to be a great time. So, here's Grace.
Hi, I'm Grace G, or Grace number two. So, I don't know if I can top these guys, but I gotta admit, last year was my first time going on a mission trip. I was just like always a bit intimidated because I feel like I've never really felt at home before, like when it comes to like friends and stuff. But I gotta admit, like ever since I came on this mission trip last year, I feel like I found my home. And I remember the years when Darcy, my older sister, would come on these mission trips. I would hear all of these amazing stories, see the videos with her, and like, I was saying, I don't do that. I want to help people. So thanks to everyone here, thanks to you all for letting us come on these mission trips. And I can feel that much closer to them. I can feel seriously closer to these guys. Definitely the best decision I've ever made. And I can feel that much closer to God. So I want to say thank you all for everything.
Amen. Like Grace said, I'm Xander. I'm going to keep this short and sweet because I don't exactly know what to talk about because I've never been on a mission trip. But, you know, I'm excited to go. Sadly, I'd have to suffer 10 hours in Carmen's car. But, you know, I guess I'll survive. I do get aux. I'll be able to play some amazing songs. But, I'm definitely excited to spend a week with the youth group and, you know, meet some new people. Yeah, I'm going to help you out.
All right, guys, hello again. I would never let you guys leave without hearing my spiel of how excited I am on the mission trip. I know you guys were really looking forward to that. So anyway, again. Anyway, I wanted to say, obviously, all these people, we are very excited to go on the mission trip. We've gotten very close since the mission trip last year, especially on the mission trip. All the people who were on it, even the people in the audience, we all grew really close in the span of a week. Some people we hadn't even met yet. I didn't know Sean that well. I hadn't seen him since I was five. But we all grew very close, and since then have just been going on more trips and seeing each other every Sunday, and it's really become like a family. We feel home every Sunday, and I definitely look forward to seeing them. But it wasn't always that way, because I know. But like I understand for the newcomers, it's their first mission trip. Last year was my first mission trip too. And it was also my first time meeting a lot of the people on the mission trip, so like some of the new people, I was really scared. Like Sean, the youth pastor, knows I didn't really want to go like for the first like few days leading up to the trip. It was like a last minute decision, but they kind of swindled me. I ended up on the trip, and it was like the moment I got there, I knew I was meant to be there, because Juliana, it was all her. It was her, my bestie. Because we got into the classroom we were going to be sleeping in for the week, right? And I was like, all right, guys, we're setting up the beds later because right now I'm leading an art lesson. That was the first thing I decided to do when I met them all. I led an art lesson, and Jules over there was my pupil. Marissa led an art lesson with me. We all grew very close, very early, and I led an art lesson to the people who who didn't really want to be, they might not have wanted to lead, like, learn art. Heather was one of the pupils. They might not have cared, but we all, it definitely helped me grow closer to them all, and now here I am, their favorite person. Everyone here is favorite person, I'm sure. And I want to say, if any of your kids might be, it might be their first time, I am always everyone's first friend, right, Natalie? I was Natalie's first friend, Lily. I mean, Lily was friends with Aubrey before she was friends with me, so I can't take that. Hi, Aubrey. Aubrey's also my friend. I stole everyone. And, well, there's like 10 people who are related, so I kind of got that first friendship stolen from me. But I am the best friend of everyone here. Even you, who doesn't know you're my best friend yet. We're bros. Okay. Anyway, that's me. And I'm so excited to go on another. You too, hi! I'm so excited to go on another mission trip with all these people, and especially my bestie Brenna here, who is this her first time. I dragged her here with me one day. So we're gonna have a great time, but I'm gonna pray us out, and you guys will stop hearing me ramble. Anyway. Dear Lord, thank you so much for all the lovely people a part of this youth group, and I pray you so much that you were able to bring them into my life, Lord, through all the miraculous ways that they started coming to youth group, and all of these people in the audience that will go holler to everyone they know to bring more people into my life, and more best friends for me to swindle into coming every Sunday, and I just thank you for making a second home for me, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Okay. And we now have our ushers.
Absolutely fantastic.
My favorite youth group memory is probably the lockdowns. Everyone just together, we had a lot of fun, and then afterwards we held out with like the pancake breakfast and just wanted the car wash and all that.
To glorify God in everything we do means to live our lives reflecting on God's character and values. Like being honest, treating others with respect, being caring and kind. Also, the ability to serve, just simply putting God first to move on His love and ways.
Yes! I decided to join because a lot of people around me decided to join, but I never would have expected what came of it.
Hello everyone, my name is Grace Kennedy, and being a student leader means something different to everyone, but to me, I really value the community in the youth group, and I make sure that everyone who comes in on a Sunday night is like welcomed and has some place to go, especially if they're like a new youth or if they're younger especially. And I make sure that they have like a friend to like look forward to on Sundays, and that's gotta always be me because I'm definitely the loudest. And I do acknowledge that about like the community, I value like the spiritual component more than anything else. And I acknowledge the fact that all the kids coming in, even the older ones too, like coming in on Sunday nights every time they're on their walk with God, and I make it priority in my time at youth group and outside of youth group that I am one of the factors just pushing them towards this group.
I think they've all affected us in a very positive way. Like they allow us to do fun things like fundraisers, like for the pancake breakfast, they let us like go on mission trips. And like it's overall like a very good opportunity for us to come together and overall come to God and make great memories.
Coming to youth group impacted my life when I get to hang out with all my friends and getting to experience mission trips and different fundraisers that we do as a youth group.
My first impression of the youth group was I thought everyone was super welcoming, and I thought everyone was like helping each other on their path to God and following the Holy Spirit. And it just made me want to join because everyone seemed like really close friends and it felt like a really friendly place.
You know, my family, we've been looking for a while. We kind of bounced around in a couple churches. We're trying to find a church to call home where, you know, not just the pastor, but the pastor's wife would have the kind of passion for the Philadelphia Eagles that two-pronged approach and shared passion and understanding of the importance of, you know, considering the schedule of the team in terms of planning and to understand gravity and even some of the superstition that's involved in being an Eagles fan and all things like that. So it took a long time to find out.
I come here every week and lead worship because I'm on fire for God and there's no place I'd rather be.
It feels really great. I grew up going to youth group, and then I was a youth leader before I had kids, and then took a break from youth group. I haven't been involved in it much. Then when we came to Trinity, I got the chance to be involved again. And I was a volunteer before my son started attending, so now I'm a volunteer and a parent, and it's great. I love being part of this part of my son's life. I love getting to be part of these lives here at Trinity. And it's fun because my mom was my youth leader when I was a kid, so I feel very close.
So for me, volunteering with the mission trip, which was a last second decision, ended up with me volunteering as a leader with the youth throughout this whole year. And it's been a really amazing experience. For the mission trip, I knew that they were looking for another female leader. And two of my sons were going on the trip, and the week of the trip worked for me. So I decided to volunteer about a week or 10 days before the trip actually left, and I really didn't know what to expect. I had never been on a mission trip before, and I had never worked with the youth before, and other than my own sons, I didn't really know any of the other youth. I knew the adults, but not well, so it really was this big leap out of my comfort zone. The mission trip itself was an amazing experience. There was so much benefit for me working with the people in the community who were disadvantaged. It was really amazing to be able to help others, to impact them, and to listen to their stories. So that part I expected. But what I didn't expect was how amazing it was to see the youth experience those same things that I did. When we left, not all the youth knew each other. Some of them were completely new to the group. Some of them were more reserved and held back, didn't really know where they fit in. And some of them were pretty young, and it was their first time being away from their families. And in that week that we were away, the whole dynamic of the group changed. The kids just formed these wonderful connections with each other. They had spent this week working together and supporting each other and learning from each other and laughing together and crying together. And by the end, they were this closely knit group. And people who had been more reserved in the beginning, they were letting their personality shine. Kids who had started out a little timid or unsure because they were a bit younger, were proud of themselves and more independent. It was really wonderful to see. And then to see the way that serving others had changed them, the way it touched their lives, to see people who were less fortunate than them, and to be able to be integral to helping them. By the time we got back, we weren't strangers to each other anymore. We were really close and connected. I left with just my two boys, and I came back, and they were all my kids. And it was after that that I decided that I wanted to keep being a part of their journey, that I wanted to keep coming back and seeing how their faith grew and how different experiences changed them and just being part of their lives. So I ended up on this last minute, 10 days before they left decision, and I've been volunteering for the entire year as one of the leaders, and it's really been a wonderful experience.
It took a process of unlearning the false things about God and growing up in a non-religion household, and relearning it going to be through the words of God and the message, feeling the love and support everyone shared for each other. They had everything in common, or the only thing in common they had was believing in God. And, you know, during when I first went to youth group, there was a part of me that felt so empty and alone and broken, and I didn't like who I was at the time as a person. But I started to go into youth group, and I kept winning. I was excited. I couldn't wait to go, you know, Sunday nights were these nights where nothing, anything that happened in my week that made me feel upset just went away. And all I could feel was this love and support, and that it was a family. And, you know, I don't know when, but one day I looked in the mirror, and I knew that part of me that felt empty, alone, and broken didn't feel that way anymore. I felt so whole and complete, and that I had changed for the better, and that I would smile waking up, looking forward to a new day, looking forward, you know, hearing more of God's words. And it's that love that in the darkest hour, the darkest nights, if everyone's around or no one's around, God is there and He loves you. And that type of, you know, feeling, it's indescribable of how unbelievably happy and complete you feel. And once you feel it, you can't go back from it. And I knew that the path I had to go down, the only path I could go down was to choose to follow God, because I could not feel that feeling of, you know, family and love and just that completeness in you. And, you know, ever since, I look forward to youth groups, I look forward to doing trips and volunteering and, you know, talking to my friend about our daily Bible verses. And it's just a part of me that I never want to go back.
Hey guys, it's Sean. month ago, everyone sees it, the parents see it, the kids see it, and it just has been a true blessing to be here with Trinity and to serve these young people. Youth group was very important to me many years ago. I had a really rough upbringing. I grew up poor. I grew up different than everybody else. I had a lot of things going on in my life that I didn't even know how I was going to ever get out of, or if I would ever have peace. And then this church came along back in my day. Tug was my youth pastor, and I'm sure you guys have seen him around church with his kids who are in the youth group. And youth group really, on its own, through God, of course, giving God all the glory, saved my life. I could have gone down a very different path that I've seen other people in my family go down, but youth group was that one factor for me that just brought me enough peace to keep coming back. And every time I went back, I learned something new. I made a new friend, and it was just amazing. And that's what I wanted to do with this youth group. I wanted to be that peace for somebody who really needs it, and to give back because of how important youth group was to me. Through this last year, I've learned a few important things just through like giving my goals up and following what the Holy Spirit wanted me to do in the group. And that was to create an environment where they feel safe and they feel loved and they feel appreciated and they feel heard. That they can come here and they know that they have a family to back them up no matter what. After we established that, it became something different and my goals started to change. I wanted to teach these kids things that would outlast even my career here. I wanted to teach them that God loves them. They are His masterpiece and nothing will ever change that. He will always love them. The second one was that having a relationship with Jesus is really important. Jesus wants to hear from you. He wants to see you. He wants to talk to you. And He wants to love you. He wants that two-way love back and forth. And that's really important because I think sometimes young people can struggle to know where they're at in this world and truly not really know who they are. And sometimes when you don't know who you are, it's hard to love yourself, right? And that's one thing that through loving Jesus, you really learn to just love yourself, to love others. And my work was cut out for me really easy because these kids are just so loving and amazing, and I couldn't ask for a better group of people here now. The third one was something I learned on the mission trip last year, was that faith without works is dead. And I know that sounds a little bit harsh, but we really learned that the best way to show love is to serve one another, right? Because you're not just telling someone you love them, you're showing them that you love them. And that has just been huge for me. That's why I try to be a part of as many things as I can throughout the church, like PBS and 456 and all these different things, just because I want to show these kids in the congregation how much I love them through service, so that I can lead by example to the kids. And that leads me to where I kind of like came up with the name of the group, because people ask me questions all the time. How's it going? Tell me some of the highlights. And it's really hard to put into words just how amazing it is here. So I found a Bible verse and a name just to show you guys. In the same way, let your good deeds shine out for all to see, so that everyone will praise your heavenly Father. That is Matthew 5:16. Because the one thing that I realize is that here at Trinity, we are loved. Here at Trinity, we are appreciated. And here at Trinity, we shine.
You ready, Carmen?
make his face shine upon me. Be gracious to you, the Lord turn his face toward you and give peace. Monsters blessing, amen.
He is for you.
touch and bless with your grace and love. As we take our worship, praise, and prayer from this place and into our daily lives, may our lives be sustained through the love of our Heavenly Father. In this summer season, may we feel the presence of our Savior walking beside us.